Hello and welcome to the grokshop. For those who might know, I've had a previous video regarding how to limit the volume limiter, initially called disable the volume limiter in Android phones. And while that solution was effective for a while, eventually I found it to be either totally ineffective or somewhat ineffective. That solution involved using the music app that's built into a lot of Samsung phones, and the problem could be that there were some updates that overrode it, or it could have just been a problem all along and I got lucky. But anyway, this is a new solution that seems to be more effective, and I've been using this for a few months now, so I definitely wholeheartedly recommend those of you who are frustrated by this volume limiting pop-up to give this a go. The solution that I'm using here is a macro app, and the particular app that I'm using is Macrodroid, but there's a lot of macro apps. I'm not necessarily endorsing this one macro app, but the idea behind macros is it's task automation. So you may have seen macros before on your PCs or MacBooks. Same concept for your phone. So you'll have a trigger, and when a trigger happens, you'll be able to set different actions, and you define what kind of triggers and what kind of actions that you want. And usually, like these apps, they'll let you do a few macros before you get into having to pay for the app. There's still advertisements in these. You'll see ads pop up in this, but whatever. It's only when you're configuring it that you have to worry about that. So for example, here you can see I have Bluetooth connect for my trigger, volume change for my action, and none for the condition. And this is what I've been running for quite a while here. And I'm just going to go ahead and delete this and show how to set this back up and then set up some additional macros as well. To delete a macro in this app, you just select the macro and you get into the macro page and hit the little trash can at the top right. Okay, now I assume everybody pretty much knows how to download the app from the Google Play Store. Once you have the app downloaded, fire it up and create your first macro by clicking on the add macro plus sign. So the first thing you do is select your trigger. I think for most people, Bluetooth connect is how they listen to their audio. And I certainly do, but I also use the 1/8-inch jack sometimes. So start with the Bluetooth option, and then I want to trigger when the device is connected. So now the question becomes, connected to what, right? So you can specify exactly which devices you want this volume setting of 100%, which is what we're going to set it to apply. Or you can just say, you know, do it for any device, which is what I do. Okay, so as I mentioned, I also use the 1/8-inch jack. One of my old cars does not have Bluetooth, so I use the little cable, and so I need to select, let's see, headset connect, headphone insert remove. So obviously you want to be careful with setting max volume on this if you're actually using headphones. You might want to set it to something less than 100%. Okay, so now at the very top of the list, it pins the triggers. So you can see here I got my two triggers, Bluetooth connect and headphones inserted. So as you can see, there's a literal plethora of trigger options, and it's easy to see how this could get addicting, automating different tasks. Now I'm going to add device boot, and this is something that I probably will turn off because I don't always want my media at 100%. And besides not doing it boot, you might want to have triggers to turn it down sometimes. But that's just how frustrated I am with this problem. Okay, so next here in the middle at the top, click on your actions. And then this is where you basically do stuff, okay? Based on the triggers that you just set up, you want to do what? Well, what we want is when we connect Bluetooth or the headset or boot in this case, we want to change the volume to 100%. So tap the volume change option. So the main volume at issue will be the media / music one. And right here is where you can force it to be whatever percentage you want when you make that connection. For me, I want it 100% because I can control my volume with my car stereo knob. I don't need two volume controls. And like I said in the comments, I certainly don't need to be fiddling with my phone trying to figure out why I can't hear my music, unplug my device, and suddenly the radio is super loud because I had to turn it up so loud because my phone was turned down. Well, y'all know what I'm saying. So be aware that you can set volumes for other stuff like your Bluetooth voice call volume. You may want to limit those as opposed to the media volume. But be aware, if you have a regular headset and you're listening to media, that media volume could blast you, okay? So that's pretty much it. The third rail here is constraints. And basically that limits when your actions take place. If, for example, you didn't want to turn your volume up when the battery was low, you could constrain it to where your battery has to be over a certain level. You can constrain based on location and all kinds of good stuff. It's pretty neat. All right, when you're done, you can just click the check mark at the bottom down there, and then you'll get a chance to give a name to your macro. Maybe something creative like nanny. Okay, we'll go with that. Okay, yeah, this is great here. You get a chance to see ad pop up. So this is the kind of thing you can expect just when you're configuring. After it's configured and set up, no ads, of course. So now back up at the main menu, you'll see the one next to macros there. You can just tap on that little square and you'll see your macros configured like I had shown earlier. You can tap your macro and reconfigure it however how you want. Here I'm actually going to go ahead and create another macro and break out the boot into a separate trigger so that on boot I can moderate my volumes and set them accordingly. And then maybe later, probably not right now, but maybe later I'll make another macro to reduce the media volume when the Bluetooth is disconnected. Because otherwise, sometimes, you know, you'll be in a quiet room and you go to watch your video and it's super loud and that's not too cool. So that's something else I'll probably do later. But I think you guys get the gist of it. Let me know what you think. And thanks a lot for watching. Hopefully, once and for all, this gets the annoying pop-up problem with the volume limiter resolved for you guys. All right. Good luck. Take it easy.